Throughout the consultation process, the Kimberley Land Council took instructions from traditional owners across the Kimberley. The traditional owners were organised in terms of their native title claim groups as set out in the Native Title Act. In December 2007, senior cultural and organisational leaders met to design a fair, transparent and culturally acceptable process for delivering GAS consultations to affected traditional owners. February 2008, senior cultural and organisation leaders met in Broome to refine and endorse the process and to elect a senior leadership group with the responsibility of meeting with all coastal traditional owners to explain the process and encourage participation. In March 2008, the senior leadership group and the Kimberley Land Council Chairman, Executive Director and Deputy Director travelled to each of the 14 coastal claim groups to introduce and explain the consultation process and to encourage involvement. All traditional owners for each claim group were invited to participate in these meetings. Meetings were held at Kalumburu, Wyndham, Broome, Bickle Bay, One Arm Point, Mowanjum, Derby and Bidgetanga. May 2008, the senior leadership group and Kimberley Land Council Chairman, Executive Director and Deputy Director held meeting with groups of claim groups as cultural blocks to consider issues and implications from development proposals that crossed over claim group boundaries and to look at the bigger picture. Cultural block meetings were held at Derby, One Arm Point, Broome, Wyndham and Kununurra. At the above meetings, each claim group were asked to elect four representatives to sit on a traditional owner task force. Elections to this task force were conducted openly and transparently. Traditional owners elected their own representatives. The traditional owner task force was responsible for receiving, discussing and analysing the range of complex information relating to GAS development on the Kimberley coastline, providing feedback to the wider claim group, representing the views of the wider claim group to the traditional owner task force. The traditional owner task force met regularly during the GAS consultation process and directed the Kimberley Land Council to provide them with as much information as possible on all aspects of the proposed LNG development. June to September 2008. The traditional owners task force met many times between June and September. A large amount of complex information was presented to the task force and members were provided with information to take back to their claim groups. The task force also visited the LNG processing facility on the Burrup Peninsula in the Pilbara. August to September 2008. Consultation meetings were held with each of the claim groups for country where potential sites had been identified by both the traditional owner task force and the state government's Northern Development Task Force. At this stage of the process, traditional owners for each claim group made decisions on whether they would continue to look at the possibility of having an LNG facility on their country. From an initial list of up to 40 possible sites, and later 13 sites put forward by the state's Northern Development Task Force, traditional owners elected to keep four sites on the table: Prices Point, part of the Jubba Jubba claim groups; North Head, part of the Nyulnyul claim group; Anjo Peninsula, the Oungu claim group; and Gordon Bay, part of the Gurradjuri claim group, which was later removed. On the 6th of September, the WA state election took place and the consultation process established by the old government was delayed, pending the policies of the new government. On the 15th of October, the new Premier, Colin Barnett, announced the state's shortlist of sites. The Premier nominated North Head as his preferred option. The state's Northern Development Task Force commenced studies for each of the sites and called for public submissions. Traditional owners through the Kimberley Land Council lodged a submission outlining our concerns and issues. Despite no clear policy position from the new government, traditional owners and the Kimberley Land Council continued with the consultation process already underway. During October, senior cultural bosses and traditional owners task force members visited communities and leaseholders on the Dampier Peninsula to let them know what was happening and to hear their issues and concerns. The traditional owner task force was reconfigured to contain eight representatives from each of the remaining claim groups. In November 2008, the traditional owner task force representatives from the four claim groups still considering LNG development on their country met several times. These meetings were dominated by the Premier's announcement of his personal preference for a North Head location for LNG development. The group called on the Premier to allow the process of identifying a potential site for a gas hub to continue without interference, in order to ensure that any development occurred in a socially, culturally an environmentally sustainable and responsible manner. Also in November, Traditional Owner Task Force representatives met with the broad membership of each of the remaining claim groups, providing them with information and listening to the issues that were important to traditional owners. As on previous occasions, all members of each claim group were invited to participate in these meetings. Once again, each claim group decided to leave their locations on the table for further consideration of LNG development. In December, development proponent Woodside made an offer to traditional owners of compensation in return for permission to establish an LNG facility on the Dampier Peninsula. This offer was not acceptable and was rejected by traditional owners. The Northern Development Task Force report on the four remaining sites was provided to government. The Premier announced James Price Point as the preferred site. He stated that traditional owners had until 30th of March deadline to agree to a suitable location, otherwise he would use compulsory acquisition to take the land. February 2009, a combined meeting of the Galarabalu Jabba Jabba and Jabba Jabba claim groups was held to give instructions on how to proceed. As with all claim group meetings, all relevant traditional owners were invited to attend. At this meeting, traditional owners elected a Jabba Jabba negotiating committee to act on their behalf and instructed the Kimberley Land Council to enter into negotiations with Woodside and the state to see if a suitable agreement could be made in relation to the Price's Point site. March to April 2009. A range of meetings involving the negotiating committee, Woodside and the state government were held during March and April. The Commonwealth government also had an observer at these meetings. On the 15th of April 2009, a meeting of the Galarabalu Jabba Jabba and Jabba Jabba claim groups was held. All appropriate traditional owners were invited to the meeting. Both Woodside and the state government presented information to traditional owners on what they would be willing to include in any agreement. The traditional owners voted with a significant majority to enter into a heads of agreement with the state and Woodside to move forward in the process of allowing an LNG facility at Price's Point. This agreement was conditional on environmental and cultural heritage requirements being met. Key points about the process. The process was clear and transparent and was driven by traditional owners. All decisions were made by traditional owners. All traditional owners were invited and given every opportunity to participate in the consultation process. At all times, the Kimberley Land Council acted under instructions from traditional owners. The Kimberley Land Council made their best efforts to provide information to traditional owners so that they could make informed decisions. The right people made their own decisions about their country.